Welcome back, friends, to another episode of Cubic Cauldron SMP. Yes, I am in a 3x3 hole. What am I doing? I am doing some work on the tunnel to the Guardian Farm. It's been a while since I've played any Minecraft. I just haven't really had the inspiration to play Minecraft. I come on to play and then like, and then now I feel bad because I haven't made a video. And I'm a terrible person. I apologize. But, yeah. You know, sometimes you're a terrible person in life, and, you know, I guess. And, you know, sometimes you just kind of feel a little bit down, and that's annoying. Good thing I don't plan on putting any zombie is going to annoy me. Good thing I don't plan on putting any like wood in this tunnel. It's going to be sandstone and probably words. I'm probably going to use some words in my speech. I may do at some point, you know. I just need to figure out what them words are, yeah. But I can words good. I'm really good at grammar. I'm probably gooder at grammar than you are. But that's neither here nor there. And go away. When did it take more than two swipes to kill a creeper with a sword? Unless it's two with a jump attack. I thought it was whatever. In any case, I'm probably going to use some prismarine with this build. I'm going to mix the two sandstone and prismarine kind of together to see what it looks like. If it looks like turd, then obviously I'm not going to use it. Another idea for a decorative block is upside down stairs, and I'll show you why in a moment. Alright, let's go ahead and... Oh, maybe not upside down stairs. Because I was... Whoa. What is that? Oh, yeah. Look at them. Look at them. So, I do need to actually replace these with redstone lamps at some point. I'm not really too fussed about it, to be honest. And I also need to put a overflow back there. So, when any of these get filled, the rest of it just goes to the garbage. Either that or just an overflow storage silo. Okay, now let's go ahead and grab some sandstone. Yes. I thought sandstone had texture top if it was stairs upside down. Oh, they do. See that? That actually looks kind of nice, to be honest. So let's go ahead and grab some sandstone. Is that just regular sandstone? It is indeed. Let's grab some sandstone slabs too, because... Let's go ahead and do this. Upside on slabs. Okay, smooth. This may actually be the more efficient way of doing this. Is using slabs. It annoys me when people do this, but I'm going to do it to save resources. As I say save resources, I waste them anyways, whatever. Brilliant. Nicely done, Ben. And I don't even have wood on me to make a crafting bench. There's like 50 million of them in the other room I just left. And heaven forbid I bring one with me so I can craft more slabs. You know why? Because that would be an intelligent thing to do. Craft more slabs before I leave. That would be also an intelligent thing to do. Let's grab another stack of roux. of sandstone, make another 3 stacks of slabs. There we go. 2.5 rather, but whatever. Okay, let's see if I can do a little bit of efficient building here. Alrighty then. There we go. Really? I know I could do regular slabs, then I don't have to worry about how bright this area is. I tell you what, if I had a dollar for every time I misclicked, I'd have a lot of dollars. I'd probably be able to give Bill Gates a run for his money. Literally. Really? You know what? You can stay there. I'm not even going to bother with that piece. Okay, brilliant. So annoying when you misclick. A little bit more information on video shenanigans. One of the main reasons why I've been a little bit irritated with Minecraft and kind of down about things is Omnicraft. I love Omnicraft, I love the people there, but you guys recall I complained about neighbors and I was having issues, and lovely neighbors were the cause of said issues. I'm not going to go into too much detail about it because the issues were resolved. So, you know, it's behind us. But every time I went to go play Minecraft, I just got so irritated about certain shenanigans that went on in Omnicraft, to the point that I didn't even want to play Minecraft at all. It just made things annoyingly not fun for me. So I realized that I should probably do, maybe, like, if I'm irritated with Minecraft, maybe record some other videos. That way you guys get more content. Obviously, I realized this a little bit belatedly, but I do have a plan. I'm going to say a plan, but what I mean is I have something I want to do, but I don't know if I'm going to do it. And that is, I want to do a playthrough of Terraria 1.3. I would like to... Really? I am an idiot. Okay, I brought the crafting table with me so I can create more half slabs, and I forgot to bring sandstone blocks so I can create more half slabs. So, basically, it made the point of bringing the crafting table moot. It's so ridiculous. I'm an idiot sometimes. My stupidity astounds me at times, I tell you. We just make a stack. So I want to do a playthrough of Terraria 1.3. I haven't really done a playthrough. I've beaten the Moon Lord with one of my friends, but like, I haven't done a fresh start from a baby playthrough of 1.3, and I kind of want to do that. 6, you dummy. And I was thinking that could be a good idea for like a playthrough or something. And also, Don't Starve. I love that game. I've been playing the crap out of it. I have a friend of mine. You guys who watch my streams, I haven't even streamed in a couple weeks. I'm really sorry for that, guys. I want to get into it more. Nope. I don't have armor, so, like, look at my armor. It's just iron pants and boots. And diamond boots. But, I don't know, like, Don't Starve together, I want to play Don't Starve, but I haven't decided if I want to play single player or Don't Starve together. Like, do a playthrough of that, or just an LP. Gotta make a fun time of it with P. Diddy Tech is who I'd be playing the Don't Starve with, and probably occasionally Ubisaurus. So that's cool. Or Ubisaurus, that's your league name. Or I think it's Ubisaurus Rex, like the R-E-K-T. It's great. I don't know. They're both busy at university, and I think they also work. So, I have to come up with some sort of schedule with Diddy. I'm not going to melee this guy because, as I said before. Okay, that was kind of pointless, to be honest. Ooh, what is that? Is that what I think it is? Fire resist. That means I can go nether things. I guess. Let's do this. Bam. Bam. Okay. Moving on. So don't starve together. I'll have to kind of work things out with Diddy. Like, we started playing a little bit, and then literally a few days after we started playing, don't starve together, put on an update so you don't need to use a dedicated server to have access to caves. So you can now have access to caves on the client through don't starve together. So that's brilliant. Yeah, now this big old tunnel. Oh god, this is annoying. Okay, so. Sorry about this big kind of a talky episode, but I kind of wanted to get some progress done, and I could have done this in a time lapse, but, you know, then you guys don't get to talk to me. I mean, rather, I don't get to talk to you guys, and you guys sit there and listen to me blather on about a bunch of stuff that you guys probably can care less about. So, I'll have to chat with Diddy once I get a hold of him, to be honest. We are not the best at being online at the same time. And besides, he plays on the PS4, and Dead Island Draka just came out, and he's a big zombies guy. So, obviously, while Dead Island Draka is still new, he's probably not going to be on the PC as much. Like, all his free time outside of work and outside of school is probably going to be done playing zombies, which I don't blame him. I wish I wasn't a poor person and had a PlayStation 4 so I could also play I'm just gonna call it Derazendratch. That sounds dumb. I can't do that. I cannot butcher the German language that badly. Sorry, guys. So you're gonna have to deal with me semi butchering the German language by not adding the phlegm sound at the end of Derazendratch, because I cannot speak words with phlegm. It's really hard for me. I don't know why. In any case, I digress. Next time I chat with them, I mean, come to think of it, I do have the PlayStation, the PSN app, so the PlayStation app, that's what it's called, yeah. I do have that, so I could easily message them via that and get a hold of them and then chat with it. And what we would do, the format would be, we'd probably record a week or maybe even 2 weeks of videos at once. Like in one sitting or two, like over the weekend or something like that. And then we'd edit them into X amount of episodes or X number of minutes for episode. And then I would upload them all at once and program them. Like, yeah, you gotta program them, guys. And schedule them. So I could do that. I'll just have to see about getting a hold of him. Let's grab this. Okay, what was this thing? Ah, yes. Now, as far as the Terraria playthrough, I could play co-op because, speaking of German, I got a German friend. He's pretty cool, he really enjoys Terraria, and we play it together occasionally. And by occasionally, I mean I think we've only played together like once or twice. But I don't know. I prefer, to be honest, to actually play Terraria solo, because a lot of my boss strats are solo boss strats, and I don't know. Like, I don't. I did not want to mine that. I did not. I'm an idiot. I didn't want to mine those with my pick. I wanted to mine them with Silk Touch. What was I saying? Ah, yes, Troy. Like, all the strats I know for bosses and grinding and just various things like boss arenas and just grinding arenas and stuff like that are solo strats, and I don't know anything about multiplayer strats on Terraria, so I'd essentially be playing the game from scratch, like learning how to play it again. So I don't know if the playthrough will be done co-op, but you know, whatever. I'm sure you guys don't care as long as you guys could see some Terraria. I know that when 1.3 came out, I did have a lot of people, and by a lot of people, I mean like a whole whopping 3. So all 3 of you guys who asked me about Terraria, you know who you are, and I do plan on bringing Terraria back to the channel. It will not be on console this time, mainly because I have a PS3, and, well, like, every port on the PS3 is crap, so, yeah, sorry. If you're a PS3 fan, I'm sorry, but, truth hurts, man. Words, trying to come up with words that fill blank, empty spaces of not words. So I just randomly say words in a song tone, and then you guys leave the video because of my terrible singing. Okay. It's okay. I'm aware that my singing voice is not the greatest in the world, and by not the greatest in the world, I'm pretty sure that Beethoven probably have been able to sing better than I can. And that was a deaf joke. I'm allowed because I'm half deaf. Maybe that's why my singing voice is terrible. So, in case you guys didn't know, I'm half deaf. And insert the more you know little rainbow arrow thing. By the way, I'm not actually going to insert it because I'm kind of a lazy editor. Mainly because, like, I don't know, I'm just lazy editor. Like, I'm not gonna make excuses for it. Because anything I say about my lazy editing tendencies would literally just be an excuse about my lazy editing tendencies. What? Go away! Where did you come from? Ooh, potato. Do I need... No, I don't need potatoes. Do I seriously not have any dirt on me? Huh. So I don't. Let me just combine stacks. Really? Out of all the pieces of gravel I could've got, I got the one little bit of gravel that's like 8. Okay, brilliant. Oh yeah, you like that? That thunder? Do you see that? The thunder strike just made my frame rate drop. Like, for like a split second, my frame rate went down like 10. Brilliant. Gravel, go away. We're not friends. Okay, so, I initially had thought about putting a railroad track down here, but I'm lazy, so I'm not gonna do that. Maybe later on down the road when I'm not feeling as lazy, and by not late, like, it's not really that I'm lazy, it's just I don't really have the resources to pull together to, make a rail, a track. I'm sure that it wouldn't be a big deal to ask Flues, because he has, like, a 15 billion railroad tracks in his house, so I'm sure it wouldn't be a problem to ask Flues. Not that I'd be able to get to his railroad tracks because of reasons. To be honest, I don't remember if I revealed it or whatever, or if the prank was revealed in the video, but Flues was pranked by a certain somebody. So, if it wasn't revealed yet, if it was revealed, then woohoo! I don't know. But, yeah, I'm sure it wouldn't be that big of a deal to ask him if I can have some tracks, because this is, it's not a personal project, it is a community project that I'm working on. But I do like to get stuff myself. Even if it is for a community build, I did ask for I did ask for like resource donations when I made the elevator because at the time I didn't have a looting sword, so slime wasn't exactly the most common thing, and I'm packing those in when I need to dig them out. Anyways, I am a fool. Whatever. And I'm not going back up that way because that zombie is going to wreck me. Sure. Instead of going all the way back, why don't I dig the floor out all the way back? And before you even mention it, I'm not leaving that as cobblestone. I only put that there so I, because I was kind of tired of jumping and bonking my head. It was quite annoying, if I'm going to be honest. Another thing I had thought about doing is actually doing a slime block elevator up to the entryway, but at the moment I can't be bothered. And yeah, so whatever. I think that a staircase is fine, you know, especially considering you get like about a quarter way up the staircase and you get the, you get about a quarter to halfway up the staircase and you get the speed effect from the beacon, so it's not that big of a deal. After I finish digging out this floor, I'm going to do a jump cut, and by a jump cut, I'm just going to cut to see how much time is left on the video, because I did not even look at the clock when I started recording, which is rookie move on my part. And by rookie move, I mean rookie move. I can't think of any other way to explain that, but whatever. I would like to have more often videos. I say that a lot, I know I do, and you guys are probably sick of hearing it, but with the Terraria series coming, Terraria is a really easy LP series, it's a really easy game to do an LP on, because, I'm peeing on things, yeah, in any case, it's a really easy series to do a Let's Play on, because you can just play for a couple hours, or, you know, like, play for an hour, even, and just record just straight hour, and then you can have, right there, you got 5 20-minute episodes, and there you go, you got a week's worth of episodes. And my personal preference when I watch Terraria videos, I do not like really long ones, and even though you guys know my channel, I like putting half hour or longer videos up. Oh, I thought, I was like, wait, I don't have inventory tweaks, why did that, automatic thing, words, you know? Oh yeah, before I get too far along here, I'm going to stop the recording here, I'll be right back, I'm going to see how much time we have left. I'm probably overestimating how much time we've been recording. Be right back. Literally nothing has happened since I cut the recording, and by like, I only cut the recording for not even a full 30 seconds, just long enough to tab out and check the recording, and then tab back in, start recording again. Well, I did have the take a few breaks because my cats, there are two boys, ginger cats, and basically they hit like, I guess, a cat equivalent of like puberty, so they're running and chasing each other and humping each other. And so it, most of the time it sounds like a cat house in here. Sorry, that was a really, really poor, like, horror house joke. But in seriousness, they hump each other a lot, and it sounds like there's a male cat and, like, a bunch of females, because they just howl, and it's annoying, and to be honest, I don't know what to do, because I never really own cats. So do I just let them do the giggity with each other, or, like, do I spray them? Like, I spray them with water when they're naughty. I have a squirt bottle, and I spray them, like, in the face with water. Do I like spray them with water, or does it pass? Obviously the best solution probably to get them fixed, you know, get them neutered. But as I mentioned before, poor, so. although, I think, getting a cat neutered, nope. I think getting a cat neutered, how do you like them reactions, eh? Too bad those reactions don't exist on hardcore mode, or ultra hardcore, because I probably wouldn't have died to that creeper. What was I saying? Oh no, 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 don't do that. Ah, yes. Really? Double really? You know what? Joke's on you, game. I wanted that like that. You know, I'm gonna leave that there. And then other members, I can't do that because that's gonna bug me. Oh, of course. That's why it's dark here, because that jerk of a creeper blew up my torch. What was I saying? Ah, yes, cats being horny little cats. I don't know. If any of you guys have male cats or have had male cats in the past and kind of know how to deal with that, if you could please let me know in the comment section. And don't give me sarcastic answers like just throw them outside, because they're indoor cats and I live in a city, in the city, and particularly in a neighborhood where people shoot cats for fun. I live in a ghetto-y neighborhood. People have, like, everyone in the second cousin has a pit bull, and it seems like I don't mind pit bulls personally. I wouldn't own one because I don't really care for big dogs. But it seems like my stereotype for pit bulls is not that, oh, they're vicious dogs or anything like that. I'm sure they can be nice if you raise them properly. But it seems like every instance where, like, a dog kills a cat, like, the perpetrated dog seems to be a pit bull. And there's a lot of them here, and there actually has been reports of a lot of cats getting killed by said pit bulls, so. In fact, I think a previous cat that we had was killed by a pit bull, actually. Not that I'm on that particular subject. And that's, he was an outdoor cat, so. You know, it's kind of his fault for getting out. It's not that we let him out either, because, you know, moving into the city. If you're in the country, it's one thing. You know, countryside is one thing to have an outdoor cat, because whatever. But if you're in the city, you know, I don't really trust neighbors. Like, I'm a hermit type of person. I don't really trust neighbors. But, especially in my area. Yeah, I don't know. If you guys have any advice on that, I'd be happy to hear from you guys, see your input. The episode is almost over. I know this has been a really, probably kind of boring episode, because literally all I've done is just dug some blocks and placed some blocks. Although, this is block game, crazy block game, you know, Minecraft. And the point of Minecraft is to mine blocks, craft blocks, and place blocks. You know, it is kind of in the name. You know, you mine blocks and then you craft up things, you know. It's kind of in the name of the game, but some people like more progress, they like more progress being done, and I don't know, I think just for want of producing more content, I'm going to try, instead of doing my normal LP style, I'm going to try the lazy editing LP style, and... No offense to any of you guys who actually do that. I have no problem with it. There's plenty of YouTubers who do that that I enjoy watching. Like, and I'm gonna call out two YouTubers right offhand that I know that do this, and that is Syndicate and Captain Sparkles. But you know, fans of theirs have been for years. I'm not going to stop becoming fans of them just because the people, you know, a lot of people take. Get really upset with them for spending their hard-earned money, you know. I'm not going to stop being fans of theirs just because they're successful. I don't understand the logic, to be honest. I've been fans of them. I almost said friends. I was like, oh, I kind of wish I was friends of theirs, because then I wouldn't be so unsuccessful at YouTube, I guess. I don't know. I kind of detracted from, like, lost, got derailed for some reason. So, I forgot why I even mentioned them. To be honest, I literally just spaced out as to why I even brought up them. Oh yeah, lazy editing. That's what they do, is basically you just record for X amount of time, and then you slap on an intro, call it a video. There's nothing wrong with that, absolutely nothing. A lot of people enjoy that. I'm kind of giving it a try. I don't really like doing it, because it feels lazy and it feels unprofessional, to be honest. And I'm not gonna be able to finish this episode, because by the time I run all the way back and then craft more up, it's going to be past time. In fact, it's already past time. I know I've been recording for more than 8 minutes, which, by the way, when I cut the video, it was at the like 22 minutes marker. It was at 22 minutes, so I'm gonna go back and. Instead of come all the way back, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back, craft a couple of sea lanterns, and kind of show you what I have for lighting an idea I have for lighting. Obviously, if it looks dumb, another good light source that goes pretty well with sandstone is lava. But what I'll do is I'll probably go with like a yellow stained glass because it kind of matches the color of sandstone. It's similar in color at least. Or I may go with green because the sandstone, you know, desert theme, like sand and cacti, or sand and reeds, sugarcane, kind of goes together. So I may go with the green and then put lava underneath of it, or I may just do green and then green stained glass or yellow stained glass. I keep on saying one and stained grass. Stained grass, okay. And put in sea lanterns under it. I don't really want to use incorporate sugarcane into my design, even though I very well could, but I'm not going to do a mumbo jumbo, you know. Sorry about that. And no, guys, that was not like a negative thing towards mumbo jumbo. No one cares these days about things. People are just overly sensitive. So, I don't need a lot because I'm just going to kind of give you an example. So, I'm going to place a block right here. It just happened to be a full block. And then place a block right here. Bam. And place a block. Obviously, this would be a little bit more uniform than this. So I'd have, I'll have it spaced out to, like, this is, 15, where my cursor is, okay. So I can actually move this, I think, two more. So let's try this out real quick. Miscalculated. There you go. So in the middle there, even though it looks dark. Oh no, I could have left it there. Okay. Even though it looks dark, it's high enough light level that mobs should not spawn because it's 8. Ooh, wait. Oh. Let's go ahead and do this. There, now it should not drop. Yeah, 9 should be a little. I should have just kept that where it's at. So, about this space right here. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. In between each one. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I miscounted. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Oh, that was convenient. Alright, like a spacement like that. Because I actually like these little shadows here. Because it adds a little bit of moodiness instead of having it so bright that, although I don't know why. Oh yeah, I have my brightness up because of Vegas. For some reason, Vegas makes my Minecraft videos darker than what they actually are, a lot darker. Like Premiere was fine. I'm using Vegas again because of malware bytes. Is according to malware bytes. I have a correct version of Adobe Premiere. I do not. I have a legitimately paid for version that I pay for. I mean, I didn't pay this month because Malwarebytes is being a douche canoe, and I'm not going to pay for something that Malwarebytes won't freaking let me use. And I'm not going to uninstall Malwarebytes just so I can use it because computer security is more important than video, faster video editing. And besides, my old graphics card died, so the whole benefit of using Adobe Premiere is kind of gone, and that was hardware acceleration that would allow me to render my videos in like 35 to 45 minutes because of the graphics card, which this current graphics card is not compatible with hardware acceleration. Well, it says it is, but it literally does not speed up it at all. It's literally just as fast as just using the CPU. So I switched back to and on top of that, I want to do batch videos, and every time I try to do batch videos on Adobe Premiere, it just doesn't work. I know you're supposed to, like, edit the video and then you queue it instead of, you know, export, but I don't know. It's just, I can't get batch videos to work on Adobe Premiere, so when I do get a better graphics card, I'll probably switch back to Adobe Premiere because I did actually prefer it over Sony Vegas. It was a little bit more user-friendly to me, to be honest. I found it a little easier to use. In any case, I hope you guys enjoyed this. I hope you enjoyed this. Ooh, don't look that way, dummy. Hope you enjoyed this episode. If you did, smack that like rating. And tell me in the description, Ben, keep making videos. Stop taking forever to upload a video, you know? Give me some words of encouragement, please. Words of encouragement. Yeah. Even if you want to comment in the comment section saying you're a dummy, go ahead. Call me a dummy. I am a dummy sometimes. We all are. Oh, except for, like, Stephen Hawking. He's probably never a dummy, but that's neither here nor there. Hope you guys enjoyed this. Share this video with your friends. Subscribe if you're new. And bye-bye. Have a great day. Take care.